Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. Coming up in this video, we're going to vibe edit using the latest agent from Descript. We'll take a look at the updates from Anthropic, including integrations and research, and a really cool integration with GitHub that's rolled out to all users, including free users. Finally, we'll take a look at what I think is a better way of generating images using ChatGPT's 4.0 image generator. Stick around to the end to see that. Let's dive straight in with Descript. And yes, I received this email to say I'm invited to the A-team, which means I can actually test out the new AI agent.
Crazy times, right?
If you've seen the video with Andrew Mason, who's the CEO of Descript, it looks pretty impressive. So I'm going to go into new project up here. It will be a video project. Now you'll see I have a bunch of options. I can record, I can create an AI speaker, import from Zoom, or drag and drop some files. Two video files dropping in now, transcripts ready in a few minutes, and that was really easy. Now I've got my outdoor video here and I can click through and see all the different takes. I've also got the second video that I recorded in my studio. Well, rather than using Underlord, this is what has been available for quite some time in Descript, where you can tell it every single thing you want to do and there's quite a lot of features and it can get quite overwhelming. Now we just click into Agents. And you'll see, much like Cursor, this is vibe coding for video. Let me just play some of this video first of all.
All right. I'm gonna vibe code a video.
Fix the audio quality. Okay, it's analyzing the script and applying audio enhancement. And look at this here, proceeding to enhance the audio quality for all scenes. Now, this is where it becomes agentic. Not only did it improve my audio quality, but it actually took the liberty of removing words and words as well. I really like that. You are awesome.
I'm simply going to prompt it on how I want the video to turn out.
Okay, you'll notice there was an and an there, which it totally removed. Now it made jump cuts, and I might not like those jump cuts because they don't look quite cool, so let's prompt further. Cover up those jump cuts with some B-roll. Okay, it tells me it's a great idea, and it's covering the jump cuts to make the video flow. How cool is this? Now you can see it's importing a video down here. This is not me controlling Descript. This is being done by my AI agent. Let's check out our first edit.
Visuals, the effects, everything. Hopefully I'll vibe code a coherent video.
Actually, I've got to say, for a first edit, that looks pretty good. Maybe a little bit longer for the B-roll than I would have wanted, but I can simply drag and move this a little bit further in so that that cut then is shorter.
Everything. Hopefully I'll vibe code a coherent video.
And then I've got a shorter B-roll transition. Now, maybe I don't quite like the B-roll that's in there, although I think it's pretty cool, actually. I can say, can you give me three other options for the first B-roll clip? Okay, this is going really well. It's searching for three alternative B-roll clips for the first B-roll clip, and we'll present those. We can see it's analyzing search results, importing different videos already. You know what? I quite like what it's pulled in here as the final option, so we'll stick with that one. I can always step in and change things, so if I want, I can make this across Zoom.
Vibe code a coherent video.
That's a pretty cool transition. I like that. So I have pretty much not touched any tools inside Descript. The agent's doing it all for me. Now let's play this little transition here.
This is definitely the future of video editing.
Okay, that's a bit of a slow pause there. So I'm just going to highlight that section there. And I'm going to say, can you remove the awkward silence here, please? And it even says, I'll identify the exact location of the awkward silence in the script, and I'll remove it for smoother flow in your video. Okay, let's play that edit back.
Future of video editing.
Okay, this is insane. And that is so much better already. Vibe coding, just type in or speak what I want done, and the agent does it for me. But also notice here for this last bit, I'm not making eye contact with the camera. Well, let's get my agent to fix that. For the bit I've highlighted, could you make sure the presenter is making eye contact with the camera, please? We'll just hit enter, and immediately the agent is, yes, of course, I'll apply eye contact correction. Give it a moment and a cup of coffee. Take a look at this. I've opened up the layer, and we can see not only is studio sound applied, but we've also got the eye contact effect applied down here. The agent did that for me, and look, I'm actually looking at the camera. This is so wild. Let's play it back. Let's actually start from outside.
Definitely the future.
Making eye contact there, but
okay,
then
this is
look
insane.
At this.
Descript allows
nuts.
You to vibe code your own
absolutely
video,
crazy.
Meaning you're the director and you
I'm looking at the camera
in order to
I can't
edit
believe
your video
it.
Using only AI.
Okay, I did look away briefly at one point there, but yeah, that's so wild. And then, of course, I can disable this effect and look at my eyes. That's freaky. That's how I recorded the video. And this is what the agent did to make my eyes look at the camera. I can't quite get over some of these AI effects. That's very cool. If you like what you see so far, throw a like, subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. How about we just start a new chat with the agent and say, what do you think of this video? How could I make it better? So it says I can add more visual variety, show before and after, enhance the audio quality, call to action, tighten the script, and use on-screen text. Do you know what? I'm going to take that idea of using on-screen text, but rather than me do it, I'll ask the agent to do it. Okay, I love the idea of adding on-screen text. Can you add some text at the intro and also maybe a call to action during the outro bit as well? And notice it's going straight to work, but also as it does go to work, you'll also see there's rollbacks all along the way. So very similar to Cursor, if you make a mistake, you can roll it back. Okay, it says layout's been applied. Updating the scene text now. Let's have a look at the start. Yes, vibe coding with AI. Let AI edit for you. That is insane.
I'm going to vibe code a video.
Let's go to the end here and let's see.
This is insane. Descript allows you to vibe code your own video, meaning you're the director and you give text prompts in order to edit your video using only AI.
I'm absolutely loving vibe coding videos. Create a vertical clip of this for Instagram with some captions too. We'll let the agent go to work. Wow, this is repositioning everything. It's kept my eye contact as well.
Okay, this is insane. Descript allows you to vibe code your own video.
Notice it made a mistake with the word descript. It didn't spell it correctly. I just click correct here and type in descript correctly. Now, not only does it correct it in the transcript, but also here on the screen for my short. Can you make a German version of this video, please? It does say it's proceeding to translate the video to German right now. Okay, look at this. We've got a German script here. This is absolutely unbelievable. Generating AI speech, so it's going to speak as me in German. Now it tells me everything has been translated. The only thing is I seem to have lost my scenes. Well, let's play a little bit of this back and see what we got.
Das ist der Wahnsinn. Nicht der Skript kannst du den iGenes Video Deutsch Vibes programmieren. Das bedeutet, du bist der Regisseur Jits einfach Text und Waste Engine. Dein Video ausschließlich mit Kaizu bearbeiten.
Okay, I'm really glad that it worked out that way, showing you that agentic editing, agentic coding, agentic anything is not quite there yet. And I'm sure my German-speaking friends watching this video right now will agree, but at least it's a step in the right direction. The agent did its very best, and it translated my video to German. It used my voice, but it sounded like me with an English accent trying to speak awful German, and it erased my face for some reason. But that said, it did everything else perfectly, and it's only going to get better. This is the worst that Descript's agent will ever be. Next up this week, Anthropic announced some pretty cool features just the other day, including integrations. Now you can have verified MCP servers right inside Claude.ai. So I did a video yesterday showing you some great MCP use cases for Claude Desktop, but that can now be done in the web version and even on mobile, which is pretty cool. It's also got a really cool researchability where it can search the web, and this is currently available to Max subscribers. To get all the goodies, you really do need the Max plan, but with something like Zapier, you can now have Claude AI search your calendar and find all your appointments in the coming day, and then go out to your CRM such as HubSpot and research the person you're about to have a meeting with. And Zapier have improved their MCP integration. Now I can just go here to new MCP server and I can choose what I want to connect to. So you've got the coding tools like Cursor and Windsurf, but also Claude is in here. And so I can call it Claude MCP server, create it, boom, that's done. I can add as many tools as I want. All of Zapier's 8,000 plus integrations are available for me. And then it's easy to connect using one simple line, which I copy and paste into Claude. But it got me to wondering, yes, Anthropic rolled out lots of stuff to paying customers. Is there anything for free? And yes, there is. Look down here at the bottom of the settings page. GitHub via MCP is now available for all, even free users, to connect. So I'll now connect my GitHub account to Anthropic. So over here, we've got the plus symbol and I can say add from GitHub here. I'll add this old school repo that I made, a Tide Times integration for Home Assistant. Here it all is. I haven't used this for years. So let's add the whole context into Claude. And there we go. This is a Python-based application called Tide Times. It gives UK Tide information. Okay, this repo is 8 years old. How can I modernize it for the modern day? What would be best practices to make this work in 2025? It had a good old think about that, and now it's actually drafting a modern Tide Times app for 2025. Look at this. Over in the right-hand area here, it's writing out new code. I can take a project of mine that's 8 years old, and Claude is literally writing everything based on my GitHub repo to improve things. Final tool this week, not to be outdone by all the other announcements, OpenAI actually slung GPT-4o image generation into their playground. So you don't need to know any code. You can do this directly in their API playground. I'll link that up down below, by the way. So now we've got some sample prompts here. If you want to just test it out, you can use this icon down here, but also you've got settings, so you can go for square, portrait or landscape, high, medium or low quality, and there's even advanced stuff such as, do you want a PNG, a JPEG, a WebP, what kind of background do you want, transparent, and do you need any moderation as well. Generate a magical stars logo for Creator Magic. Now, if I want, I can change this times one setting to maybe times two or three or four or all the way up to 10 images at a time. I'm going to generate 4 images for this one and see how it looks. One version, let's go, oh, there's version 2, version 3, version 4. Maybe I would probably go with version 4 so I can download that. And boom, look at that. I have a transparent logo that I can use for Creator Magic should I wish to. I can go ahead and upload an image of me here. Make this into a South Park style image. And again, leaving the 4 times selected, so it's going to generate this version of me 4 times. Oh my goodness, that is totally insane. And here are 4 versions. There's version 2, version 3, version 4. That is totally cool. And thank you to Louise Brogan for giving me the inspiration on LinkedIn to generate South Park style images using GPT-4o. Turn him into a hippie with long flowing hair and a rainbow colored t-shirt. Oh my goodness me. That is scary good. Remove his beard. Yeah, slightly different face there, but you get the idea. Turn him into a lion. And boom, we have a Creator Magic man lion sitting in the chair now, thanks to GPT-4o image generation. So there you go. I actually think this is a better way of generating images with ChatGPT-4o image generation than actually using the ChatGPT site itself. This is simply the OpenAI API playground. Anyone can access it. All you have to do is link a payment method to your account and you will be charged on a pay-as-you-go basis. But if you're doing a lot of generations, this version seems to be more flexible, i.e. it can do more stuff. And also it's quicker than using ChatGPT itself. A better way of generating images, give it a go and let me know what you think. Another thing to add about this image generator is that with every generation you've got here, you can copy the code and actually make your own version of this using coding tools. And if you want to get stuck into that, next week on the channel, I am going to make a whole video about making a GPT-4o image generator using free AI coding tools. So subscribe to the channel for that one. It's coming next week. So there you go. That's everything I've got for you this week. If you enjoyed the video, then do throw a like and subscribe to my channel as I do this stuff for you weekly. I really appreciate you being there. We'll continue the discussion in my community. That's also linked up below. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.